Yeah, right? Right? All right, let's move on to agenda number 11.
All right, Madam Chairman, this is also rescinding requests. It's by Mount House Investments to rezone 1.08 acres from DR10 to R6. As you see by the zoning map on the screen and in your packet, this is a portion of two parcels and the entirety of two other parcels. There's four parcels all together. We covered the geography about this at length in the work session. The two entire parcels are vacant. The front Cranford Avenue, which is why we use the address as 207 and 209 West Cranford. The other two parcels have existing houses on them, and they both face Alden. DR10 is, as you know, an old zoning district from before the LDR. It stands for Duplex Residential 10. It is essentially the R10 zoning district that also allows duplexes if you have a little more lot here. Proposal is to rezone this portion of the property to R6 for two purposes. One, for possible conventional development of R6 zoning along West Cranford's frontage, or at least a portion of it. And also, as we talked about, and it's in the packet, the applicant is exploring the possibility of a future plan development request with a creative subdivision layout. But for rezoning purposes, we look at it from conventional design and possibilities, and we also cover that in the work section. It's all in the numbers. Character areas establish residential or residential zonings. Aerial imagery, urban forest. Note is the Timbers Apartments to the north on the other side of Cranford, pretty large apartment complex that's been zoned that way for a while. Notice the zoning map, that's the residential professional zoning, and that actually has been there since the 1980s. And while we're on this map, I wanted to remind you too, the DR10 lots that are immediately east of this along West Cranford, you notice that those are fairly narrow. Those are 60-foot-wide lots. Those are actually R6 standards. So the R6 for at least one of the lots of the applicant is already built like an R6 lot, and that seems to be the pattern running down Cranford. And then with the apartments across the street, which is why staff is primarily supportive of this. But just to clarify some of the numbers, this is the survey that shows the 1.08 acres. You see the footprint of the two existing houses. Again, he is proposing to retain those existing houses and then consolidate the side and rear yard areas into a future subdivision. If we were to look at it conventionally, we'll get to those plans here in the back. Meanwhile, subject property photographs. This is the view of it from West Cranford looking southward into the interior, vacant land. You see the back sides of those two existing houses that face Alden. This is one of the houses that's closest to Oak Street. This is the next one that's farther to the east. Remember, these are on portions of the property that are not subject for rezoning. The plan is to keep these portions as DR10. This is the view looking eastward down Alden Avenue. You see a single-family residential corridor, part of the local historic district, also part of the Berkwood North National Register District. This is also the view in front of the subject property. Looking at the Alden and Oak Street intersection, which actually has a traffic light. Again, you see residential patterns in the buildings. This is the view, however, looking down Cranford. From the subject property looking eastward, you see the apartments to the left. You also see some on-street parking going on. Conventional layouts, there's two of these in your packet to show a contrast. This is for conventional DR10, which is how the property is zoned now. Remember, the differences between DR10 or lot area and lot width. DR10 allows a house or a duplex. If you want a house, you need 10,000 square feet of area. If you want a duplex, you need 13,000 square feet of area. Compare that with R6. R6 also allows a house or a duplex, not multifamily in any of these. But R6's numbers are 6,000 per house, 9,000 per duplex. So you see in terms of lot area, one of the applicant's purposes is to up the overall density of the property by adding just a little bit of R6 density to the mix. However, the frontages are a little bit different as well. The R10, regardless if it's a house or a duplex, you have to have 80 feet of lot width. R6, regardless if it's a house or duplex, you need 60 feet of lot coverage. But this property is not so much the area that is limiting or triggering what can go on, it is the lot frontages. In your packet, I give you some numbers. Under DR10 zoning, you can have 7 lots based on area for duplex, 9 lots based on area for houses. However, there is not enough frontage on this property, if you keep the historic houses, to accommodate 9 lots. This is the most lots that you can get under DR10 zoning. And it's based on that 80-foot lot width. And because of the depth of the lots between these two streets, you get enough lot area to make it a duplex possible lot. But the number of lots doesn't change. So you're looking at a scenario convention of 7 lots in DR10. And that's with the proviso that the 2 existing historic houses remain on those lower 2 lots. Under the applicant's proposal, which is to add a little bit of R6, and like I said in the work session, the difference is 1 lot. So you have a 7 lot scenario. If you add a little bit of R6 to West Cranford, change the 80 foot of frontage to 60 foot of frontage. Remember that frontage overall is about 250 feet. It's a mathematics of 240. 60 goes into it 4 times, 80 goes into it 3 times. Hence the difference of 1 lot. So conventionally, that's all we're talking about. The applicant is still exploring many different possibilities of how to lay this out. One of the large variables in that equation is the historic district. In terms of the renovations to the existing houses, he's looking at perhaps a garden wall to encompass part of the property, the architecture of the new buildings, the changes in the streetscape pattern. There's a lot of things to review there from a historic district perspective. So until that is completed, we will not bring forward a final development proposal. But the first step is to do the rezoning. Strictly on rezoning principles, conventional development, the difference is the 1 lot. Land use pattern, which is the basis for staff's report, is based on this map here. R6 zoning is between RP and DR10 in terms of its magnitude. It's on a stretch of Cranford Avenue that already has an R6 pattern exhibited. It's across the street from multifamily. It also leaves the frontage of Oak Street alone. The staff found that is very important. It also leaves the frontage of Alden Avenue alone, which is also important to staff's review of this. So with all of that, staff has found the rezoning requests consistent with the Congress plan, the same structures of the zoning power, and which is there in your packet. We're recommending approval. One last thing I want to show you just to show some food for thought. Applicant is looking at some different ideas for house designs, sort of in the craftsman style. These are 2 of the types of styles that they're looking at. It's a matter of seeing which is more appropriate for the area. His desire, as he tells me, is to do a variety of houses within this new little subdivision. But something along these lines. The applicant is here, but I'll be glad to answer any questions you may have.
Can I ask
a
question?
You may.
So, Matt, just refresh my memory on the current zoning map we were looking at this evening, and the existing R6 lots within this DR10 that ought to represent the 60 by 150, which
gives you the 9,000.
It gives you that. So, my question to you is, why is the need to capture the backyard of the historical house?
From conventional design, there's no need for it. I mean, in terms of lots, it's extra area. So in other words, if you were to skip to this scenario, if that line down the middle of the block still remains, and in all scenarios, what it results is the lots facing Alden would be split zone. They'd have R6 in the backyard, which in terms of their development and the frontage means absolutely nothing. It's still a DR10 lot in terms of its frontage. That's what it's stuck with. The reason it is the way it's drawn is the applicant really wanted just over 1 acre of R6 to make the mathematics work for one of the proposals they're considering. And that's the only reason. The way I look at the numbers, it's just as doable, I think, with where it will end up. under BR 10 zoning and maybe a smaller amount of R 6. I'm okay with this, although I recognize the geography is awkward when you look at it conventionally. If you wanted to recommend that R 6 rezoning be restricted to an area that's smaller than this, and maybe limited to 150 feet of depth with the primary depth shown. So in other words, the R 6 would fit
that,
those four lots. And the mathematics in my mind are interchangeable when it gets too tight to delta possibilities.
Let's open it up to the public. Is there anyone here tonight who would like to speak for this request on behalf of?
Good evening. You guys work late. My name is David Walden. I'm at 5167 River North Circle, Tara. I have owned property in this neighborhood for about 30 years. I've been a property owner that rented, I'm a landlord. 2-3 years ago, my wife and I made a financial personal decision to abandon that. And at that time, we began remodeling our current homes that we own in the neighborhood and have begun to change it. It has been a great addition to the Brooklyn neighborhood, and I think we could also provide the same talents in this particular parcel that's been vacant for 3 decades. What you see in what Matt had presented is exactly what our proposal is. The top of the style of homes, we want to vary, we want to be good to go. Pretty much it.
Okay. Questions?
Ms. Warren, I'll just echo the question I asked Matt. I mean, and just shoot straight, I mean, is it a driver on this proposal if we're limited to the 150 depth? Just curious.
I don't think so. Matt's done
it. We've not talked about this.
Okay.
But
so you have four lots that face transfer.
Can we go back to that?
And Matt, actually, the renderings that you submitted are awesome. They look great. I think they'd be a great part.
And I might add, too, from the intent on the store is to own the
property. Yeah. Oh, the existing ones are?
Bring them back. A lot.
They should have been sitting there for a long time.
That one in particular has a large hole in the roof.
Yes.
So the 150 is not a deal breaker.
Just to be sure.
I don't think so. I haven't personally done the math. Matt speaks on, has done it. And I think at the end of the day, we'll be fine.
Mr. Martin, you good with that?
He's explored many different proposals that's still mixing, but he is set on doing a single family neighborhood proposal, which is one dwelling unit per lot. Mm-hmm. In a zoning district, whether it be DR10 or R6, those allow duplexes. So when you add all up the duplex possibilities, that's a lot of dwelling units. He's proposing a much smaller number, no matter how you slice the pie. What the R6 mix does, one, I think it puts the appropriate zoning on West Cranford. It also adds in the idea of a few of the lots being narrow.
So the larger lot that faces Oak Street, Mr. Walden, you going to be able to do anything with that? I'm just curious, man. Are we going to break that up and give you some more lots there? Some more?
All right. This is not a proposed subdivision plat. This is to show that if the zoning is changed, this is what you can do.
So
those four small lots, you notice they're 63 feet long.
Yeah.
9,000 square feet, those would be four R6 lots.
Yes.
Each of them big enough to hold a duplex, if you can get the duplex to fit.
So what can we do for them on this corner lot?
The corner lots would stay DR10. And so
we can't do that with it?
Well, you can. You can do a house or a duplex just like an R6, but you need more room.
You got to work with me here now.
For example, that corner lot to be a duplex in DR10, you need 13,000 square feet. And there's 2,000 square feet left over.
Oak?
It can face Oak or Cranford.
I mean, just the beautiful renderings he's got proposed on Cranford, I mean, those are gorgeous.
Well, this, all right, this is for the whole redevelopment.
Correct.
Which is everything in the land except, you see those two existing houses.
Right.
There's a lot of vacant land to the east, to the north, and northwest. He's looking at consolidating all of those open spaces together and recreating a new puzzle.
Yes.
One more slide. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, keep going.
So Mr. Paul, I'm just that law of the corner. You're looking to go forward with that too and do something there also.
It will be part of the whole program of a PD that will come back before you about next month.
Right. The PD he's looking at is for all four of these properties together, split zone between the R10 and R6.
Correct.
Okay.
His master plan encompasses all four, keeps the two existing houses, so comes up with a scenario for the rest of
so
it.
So this master plan, we're okay, I'm just speaking out loud here, we're okay if we limit this to 150 foot of depth on those old front, it's still okay?
It's still okay, the mathematics are still there.
I don't want to hurt him here.
If it were going to be detrimental to him, I would speak up and tell you.
Okay.
What makes it easy is the house versus duplex for either zone.
Okay. Right.
It works either way.
What would be, if he's going to come back in 2 months?
We can't, 2 months we go Christmas break, it'll be next year.
But still, I mean, why? He's going to come back with a PD in 3 months.
Yeah.
I mean, why do we need to make that change?
Yeah, Madam Chair, I agree with you. I mean, the applicant is standing right before us, and he has worked with Mr. Martin on the proposal. I don't know why we try to reinvent the wheel tonight on anything like that, but that's just one opinion.
I mean, what would be the advantage of doing that now, what you suggest?
Limiting
the
depth?
Limiting it to 1 feet.
There's nothing. My line of sight, I'm trying to figure out why we're capturing the back yard of this historical house. That's my only thought.
The only benefit, and this is just for the math person in me, it makes for a cleaner looking map with the existing property lines that we don't create.
With the 1 foot
zoning scenario on these lots immediately upon the zoning. Because the parcel lines are going to change until somebody can try it. It's just cleaner looking on the map. That's the only advantage.
Just saying, he's
going to
come back to us with a PD anyway.
Right, and if the PD gets approved, it's all moot. It'll all be redrawn.
Exactly.
If the PD does not get approved, or if he chooses to ignore the PD approval, then we're back to the conventional scenarios of these.
Right.
And then some of these parcels will be split zoned in the R10 and R6, which for development purposes works, it's just awkward.
Alright, is there anyone else here tonight who would like to speak on behalf of this request?
Good, are you sure you want to get up here?
Yeah. Bill and I in 1007 North Patterson Street. In full disclosure, I mean, I've done legal work for Mr. Walton before and done some for him now, but I wanted to come up here and tell y'all that I have owned property in Brooklyn North. You know, we lived there for 11 years, and I've been able to firsthand see what Mr. Walden has done to houses in that neighborhood with the renovations, and he's done an extraordinary job. And I really think this project is going to be a huge benefit for the city in this neighborhood. I know they'll do it right.
That's good.
And y'all are right. I mean, he's going to come back, we're going to come back, and I may be here with a PD plan that's going to look entirely different. So I don't know if any of this matters, but why rock the boat when it's already been set?
We'll take him out by 20 lashes after the meeting. Thank you. All right, we've exhausted our time on that. Is there anyone here tonight who wishes to speak against this request? Anyone wishing to speak against this request, if you'll come forward now? All right. There being none, I'll turn it back over to the commissioners. Any more discussion or Questions? All right, I'll call for a motion.
Madam Chair, regarding VA 2022-19, I believe, a request to rezone 1.08 acres from DR10 to R6. Per staff's recommendation, I move that we recommend approval to the City Council on this matter.
We have a motion to approve.
Second.
Okay, we have a second. Any discussion on the motion? All those in favor of the motion to approve, please raise your right hand. All those against, and the motion carries.